वेलोसिटी ऑफ मैन विथ रिस्पेक्ट टू अर्थ इज यू. वेलोसिटी ऑफ मैन विथ रिस्पेक्ट टू अर्थ इज यू, दैट इज टू राइट हैंड साइड. देन देयर इज अ विंड ब्लोइंग इन दिस डिरेक्शन, दिस इज द हॉरिजॉन्टल विंड ब्लोइंग at velocity v, making an angle theta with horizontal, making an angle theta with horizontal. So this information, this angle can be given in a question like this: wind is blowing at a velocity v, theta inclined to horizontal. theta inclined to horizontal. horizontal එකට theta inclination එකක් තියෙනවා. sometimes it can be given like this: velocity of the wind, blowing wind is v, theta north of east. theta north of east. east එකේ north එකට theta කියලා. ඒතරොන් ඔය direction terms උත් අපි දැනගන්න ඕන මේකේ මාක් කරගන්න. ඒකයි මම ඒක කිව්වේ. theta north of east, of what direction? east. east එකේ ඉඳලා උඩට theta කියලා. then we can find velocity. this is velocity of wind with respect to man. this is velocity of wind felt by this person, felt by this man. so that will be given like the man feels the velocity of wind. that is the idea. now apply relative velocity theorem. we can find velocity of wind respect to earth, velocity of wind with respect to earth. that is our target. then how to apply the velocity theorem? it is like vectors. we have two letters w and e, but we have three things. what are they? man, m is for man, e is for earth, w is for wind. using these three things we can find velocity w e, and write like this: in between w e we can put m, the third person here, man. therefore this part should be man earth. see, in between w and e, in between w and e I have introduced the new term m, man. so this can be written like this: velocity of wind with respect to earth is equivalent to velocity of wind with respect to man plus velocity of man with respect to earth. so that is the equation of relative velocity. now I can substitute velocity of wind with respect to man, that is v. what is the direction? theta north of east. value is, magnitude is v. then velocity of man with respect to earth, me is u. what is the direction? to right hand side. for this one we can construct the velocity triangle. that is the next step we are going to do in relative velocity problems, constructing relative velocity triangle. then I have to mark these velocity vectors using vectors like this. I can put the vector pq to this velocity of wind with respect to earth. there is no direction. I will put w there. then this is equivalent to pr plus rq. similar to this, I am going to introduce another new letter r between pq. and pq can be written as pr plus rq. eva ge alut letter ekak daana. oka thamai theorem ekken kiyanne. then I can mark pq vector using pr and rq vectors. first I can mark pr, that is in this direction, theta inclined theta inclined to horizontal. This is PR. Then what is the next vector? RQ. PR is there, then RQ. RQ is horizontal. RQ. This is V. Horizontal vector is U. Now this is the first vector. This is the second vector. Now we can join initial and final. That means starting point of the vectors and finishing point of the vectors. That will give you the resultant. What is the resultant? That is PQ. Magnitude is W. So this is called the vector triangle or the velocity triangle. That is the first part in relative velocity. When we are given two velocities like this and we are asked to find the third one, we have to write that in terms of these two vectors. Both these velocities, they are magnitude as well as direction, are known. They are magnitude and direction are given here. That is the most important part. When both magnitude direction are given, directly we can draw the triangle, velocity triangle like this. We can draw the velocity triangle or the vector triangle like this.